Women and children are in danger in Nigeria. Seriously, every other day we get hit in the news with one story or the other. Sometime, I think earlier this year, we got a news about one Ijoma in Enugu, a makeup artist that got invited. She didn't know it was a fake job. Apparently, one depraved lady thought she was sleeping with her boyfriend and then invited the girl for a fake job. The girl unknowingly went there and then got there. They poisoned her and she died. The other day, one favor, I forgot him, but an 11-year-old girl also got raped and killed in Lagos. And just recently, in Umoren, a young lady in Akwa Ibom State, she was looking for a job. All she ever wanted was a job. She posted that she was looking for a job on Twitter, and then someone invited her for a fake job, and then they raped and killed her. I don't understand. I don't understand. Like, it's almost like, to be a woman or a girl in Nigeria, just for the mere fact that you're a woman, your life is in danger. Hey moms, welcome back to my channel. My name is Rita. If this is your first time of clicking on my video, welcome. This is my channel, Young Nigerian Mom, where I talk about young motherhood life and all. And to my returning subscribers, thank you. Already know I really appreciate your support. So today I just want to talk about the recent happenings in Nigeria as regards violence against women, because for some time it's been disturbing me. Almost every day you wake up to one news or the other, and then the one that just happened recently, if you've been following the news online, especially on Twitter, even though it has spread beyond Twitter at this point, a young lady from Akwa Ibom, her name is Ini Umoren, she just posted a job application. She has finished, they say that she has finished school. She's just waiting for NYSC, you understand? So she posted a job application on Twitter that she really needs something that she'll be doing. She needs a job and everything. She said that she was creative and so many other things. I'll get the initial job application that she put on Twitter and put it up on the screen for you guys to see. That was all she did. And then she fell into the hands of rapists and murderers. Okay, what first happened is that someone replied her under the tweet where she posted that she was looking for a job, and then gave her his office address and everything to come for an interview. But much later, when the whole thing escalated, Twitter people now went back and saw that the person that posted that thing under, the person that posted that she should come to his office, had deleted the tweet. Not only deleted the tweet, changed his handle. And then how we even got to know that the girl was missing was that the girl called her friend in Lagos, a very good friend of hers, one Uduak Umo, and everything, and told her where she was going and was keeping her friend up to date on her movements. And even when she eventually got there, when she realized that all was not as it seemed, she tried to send her friend a voice note, a 1 second voice note. When the friend now got the 1 second voice note, so she now quickly tried to call her back. Immediately she called her back, she heard the girl screaming, and then the call ended and the phone line was switched off. And that was what made this video have to come to Twitter to start raising an alarm that her friend was in trouble, her friend was missing and everything. So the guy that posted that she should come to his office for interview had deleted the tweet and changed his handle. But you know, Twitter, if you're on Twitter, and I know that Twitter people can be FBI. Twitter FBI found the guy's new handle, found, and they found the tweet that he had deleted, and then traced the number they gave the girl to call to another account on Facebook. They now started debating whether the account on Facebook and the one that posted the job thing on Twitter were one and the same people. Anywho, after everything, the whole investigations, even I think the one that posted the job initially came out to deny that he didn't know where the girl was and everything, but it turned out that he was in on it. He was eventually picked up by the police, which eventually led to the arrest of the main murderer, the person that actually kill the girl, you understand? So maybe after being interrogated or possibly manhandled by the police to say the truth, the killer now admitted that he raped her, and when she was trying to fight back, he now killed her. Come on, why are we so heartless? What did she do? You know, the thing that pains me about Nigeria is that when something happens to a woman, they say, oh, she caused it, oh, she's a prostitute. If she was raped, they say, why was she wearing that clothes? Is she stupid? Doesn't she know that if she wears that kind of clothes that men will rape her and everything? But okay, she's a prostitute, she's this, she's that. What did this particular girl do? What did she do that she wanted a job. Someone just lured her. People just planned. Okay, and they even said that the person that killed her, that even the father, the cousin, the sister, all of them, that is just what they do. They just lure innocent women to their place and then they rape and kill them. What kind of society are we living in? What kind of society are we living in? And for these people to even do this thing, it's not the first. Because for them to have the courage, like, for you to actually be watching out for people that are posting about them needing a job online, you planned it. They've been doing it for some time, you understand? And that was how they just ended this young lady's life. Okay, they will say, women, no, you know that there's a way the world is now. When you're going out, make sure you tell somebody where you're going to. Make sure you don't go alone. Make sure you leave your location on. Make sure you call. Ini did everything. She left her location on. She her friend shared some screenshots of the WhatsApp messages. They're on Twitter. I will try to get them and leave them on the screen. She shared her location with her friend. She called her friend when she got there. She kept her friend up to date. Even when she was entering bike to get to the final location, she kept her friend up to date. You understand? And even when she felt that things were going wrong, she still tried to call her friend, but it was too late. So I'm now asking, all the make sure you tell somebody where you're going to, make sure that you leave your location on, make sure that you charge your phone, make sure that your phone is not on silent. How did he help her? How did he help her? Women are not the problem. The problem are the men and even the women killing each other. The problem are the psychopaths and the murderers that we have in Nigerian society. Not the way a woman is dressing. And not that she went anywhere without telling anybody. Okay, fine. She got there and she even tried to reach out. She tried desperately to reach out to her friend and it was too late. Okay, and then the latest on the news now is that even though the killer has been apprehended and everything, that they've also refused to release her body to her family members and everything. There are now rumors all over the internet that the family may be trying to cover it, how they are linked with one local government chairman. Nobody can verify any of this news to be true. But my point is, imagine the pain this Ines family will be going through. Who is going to console them? Nigerians move on from things a lot, you understand? We move on from things quickly because will I say that we are used to so much trauma that it no longer affects the average Nigerian. They'll just be like, oh, so sorry, what happened? Hey, what? Jesus, blah, blah, blah. And before you know it, they move on with their life. So imagine this girl's family. What's the way forward? See, serial killers and rapists, they don't happen overnight. They've probably been doing similar things, you understand, for years. And some other people have been covering them up. Maybe their family members, maybe their friends, their colleagues, maybe the authorities where they are have been covering them up. A lot of these things need to stop. We need to find a way to secure the life of an average woman in Nigeria, because believe me, everybody cannot be a prostitute. When something happens to a woman, you just label her. It happened to her because everybody's not a prostitute. And even the prostitutes, they have a right to live. You can't just snatch somebody's life because the person is a prostitute. I'm just really, really sad. And I wonder what we can do as a society to ensure that the lives of women and children are safe. And therefore, we that are mothers, the days are really, really rough. Mind who you're leaving your kids with, whether boy or girl. It doesn't even have to be an adult, you understand? Because sometimes they just brag children, give them sweets, give them something, and then send them to do one thing that the child does not understand. But maybe because he or she is related to the person sending him on such an evil errand, the child will just go and do it. Mind who you leave your kids with. Make sure that your kids are always secure. Do whatever sacrifice you have to do, CCTV, whatever it is that you have to do, to make sure that your kids are secure. Trust me, you're not going overboard, because the way Nigeria is now, things are bad. Things are very terrible. The level of moral decadence in our society now, I don't even know what to say. Gone are the days when you just leave your kids with your friends or even with your relative self that you cannot vouch for. You always have to make sure that you're up and doing in the security of your children, because the way the thing is going now, Oyo is everybody's case. This Inu Morens family now is RIP. Before you know it, after 24 hours, everybody had moved on with their lives. What wrong did she do? Why did such a cruel fate befall her? She only wanted a job and then she ended up. So I've come to the end of this video. I don't want to talk too long. I want to use my platform to wish my sincerest condolence to members of our family. I pray that God gives them the fortitude to bear the loss. So until next time, I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye bye.